Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1659, Convert Various Currencies. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Yesterday, we answered a question from Bob. Bob was trying to auto-filter a table and put in different values, and the formula autocomplete was, or the autocomplete for the table was driving him crazy. A completely better way to go. First of all, let's make this into a table again with Ctrl+T. Click OK. That way our autocomplete will work. We already had this little table up here that converts GBP to, this is the conversion rate. We have to multiply the currency amount by this to convert to GBP. So we can just add a new column here, GBP for Great Britain pounds, right? Equal this amount times the VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP stands for vertical lookup. We want to look up that currency code, comma, in this table here, and I want to lock that down. So I'm going to press F4, comma. We want the second column, so 2, and we want exact matches, so we're going to put a false at the end. All right, so the amount times the rate here in the lookup table. We're getting the second column from the lookup table. I'll press Enter, and we actually want Excel to copy that down automatically. And so just a little test here, 2,083 euros, comes up with 1799. If I do equal 2083 times 0.864, 1799. All right, so there's a single formula that gets copied down and solves the problem all the way down. You know, as I look at this 0.408, I'm going to add one more thing in here. I bet we want to round this off to the nearest either dollar or whatever there. I don't know, is it cents? I don't know. And we want to copy that formula down. All right, so there we go. A single formula that will go out to this lookup table, figure out the currency conversion rate, and then tomorrow, you know, if the rates change, if I have to do this some other day, I just come here and, you know, update the new value, like 0.62, and you see that the relevant cells will automatically update. So this VLOOKUP formula, a little bit more straightforward than using the filter in four different formulas that Bob was trying to do yesterday, but I understand, you know, there's five ways to skin a cat in Excel, and sometimes, you know, VLOOKUP is eluding you, so the other way certainly would have worked. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.